Hello and welcome. Once again, it's 9:30 on a Tuesday night. It's time for the Schadenfreude. I'm your host, Eric Holzman. I am here this week with the returning champion. She's been my co-host a few times, and she's back again this week, Ms. Renee Barnes.
Thank you for having me, Eric. It's always a pleasure coming here.
I love having you on. I get to see you at work, and then I get to see you here.
You can't get enough of me.
Can't get enough. It's great.
I know.
So how's it going?
It's going good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I have no complaints.
Since the last time since the last time everyone has seen you, what's been going on?
Nothing new. I'm loving the heat. I don't know why everybody's complaining, but I cannot complain about winter and summer. I have to pick one. And I hate winter. You already know this. I hate the cold.
I do.
So, I'm not even complaining.
Yeah, there's no... Let me put it this way. I've lived here for the bulk of my life. I've lived in this area, so this is part of the deal. Mm-hmm. You get really hot summers, and you can get really cold winters. Mm-hmm. It's just part of the deal, and you grow to deal with it. That's why I rarely complain about the weather. I really don't complain about the weather at all.
Eric, you complain about the heat all the time.
No. Hold on. Hold on. I might say it's hot. Or I might say, wow, it's really hot outside. But it's not like I'm saying, I can't deal with it. It's just what it is. It's, it's hot. Okay. Just let me in the winter. I say it's cold.
Well, I hate the winter. I'm not even hiding it. Like the winter time. I do not like to be cold. I'm uncomfortable. I don't like it.
But I do have something. There is something that kind of I have to ask a question. And I'll ask you. I've asked other people in the office, but there's a couple of you in the office that even in the summertime will wear sweaters.
In the office coats. Because they have the air conditioner up to the...
No, they don't.
I don't know. It's high.
Come on.
Yes, I have to have... I wear my sweater in the office more during the summertime than in the wintertime.
Well, that's because in the wintertime...
In the wintertime, the office is nice.
No.
And see, warm.
See, this...
It's not, I'm very comfortable during the wintertime.
No,
in the office.
No. It's not true. Because, see, our office has the floor heating. So in the morning, it's not too bad. But get to be like 2:30, 3 o'clock.
I'm happy.
You feel
happy.
Like you're walking on the sun.
I am fine.
That's how hot it is.
I don't have a problem with
it
that.
It is ridiculous. Between you, Anna Louise, you guys wearing jackets and sweaters in the summertime when it's 95 degrees outside.
But it's
humidity 80%.
It's probably 20 in
we're
the office.
Baking. God, it just bothers me. Because I don't get on people. Well, I do actually. I'm lying. I get on them all the time for it. So, yeah.
So, what's up with you, Eric? What's new?
Only bad stuff is new. Since last week, since last Tuesday, I went to play basketball last Wednesday.
Uh-huh.
And I had an old knee injury on my right knee. Well, I aggravated it again.
Yeah.
So, one thing, I think my body's telling me you're getting too old.
That's right.
The second thing is I'm... going for an MRI tomorrow night, but I did see the doctor, and he thinks I probably tore my ACL, so I might have to have surgery. Well,
maybe you were trying to be Steph Curry on the court. I don't know.
Or LeBron. No, I was just playing. I was just, playing.
Hey, when sucks. You get to a certain age, you got to put down the young people thing.
No, so the doctor's trying to, went to see the doctor on Friday, and he's sitting there, he's talking to me, and he's like, Eric, he's like, what do you want to do? Well, after the MRI, we'll tell you what you want to do. He's like, I think this is what happened. But he's like, you can live with it if you want. He's like, at your age. And I'm like, wait a second. Hold up. Like, time out. I'm only 39 years old. At my age. What are you talking about? He's like, well, you're getting older and you might not want to go through. I'm like, I'm not 65. I still want to do things that I like to do.
So wait, what does he want to do with it?
Well, no, you don't have to have surgery to repair it. You can live with it.
Okay, I wouldn't do surgery because I'm going to tell you, everybody, older people that I know that have all done knee surgery have regretted it.
Hold on, you keep saying older. I'm not that old.
No, meaning, but I don't know anybody your age that has done it, but I know older people that have done it,
right.
And they always complain about it.
I mean, I'm gonna listen to the options, but if I need it, that's what I'm gonna get.
Surgery
done.
Should be your last option.
Mm-mm,
maybe
not in
some
this case.
Kind of physical therapy or something. Well, I don't know how these injuries are, but
that's what we did last time. I did the physical therapy.
I think you should. I mean, that's just my opinion.
And it happened again. Now, last time they told me it was partially torn, but I think the doctor said that he thinks that they didn't see it clearly in the MRI, and that I probably tore it last time. So I don't know. I'm just hoping for the best. But if they do say surgery, if he says he thinks surgery is an option, I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
And then I have to pick where I want the graft to come from for my new ACL. But that's a boring story. So yeah. So other than that, been working with you. I did. There were a couple of movies that I saw this past weekend.
Okay.
I saw Star Trek Beyond.
Okay.
Which it was very good, actually. I've seen all three of the new Star Trek movies. Sorry, I saw the first one, then Into Darkness was the second one, and then this one was called Beyond. Very faithful to the story. It's a good summer movie. It's got action in it, so I would suggest you go see it.
I mean, you can suggest, but I'm not a Star Trek fan.
I know.
The last movie I saw was with my little cousin. I took him to see Secret Life of Pets.
How was that?
I liked it. It's a fun, cute movie. It's for kids. As an adult, you can enjoy it too. I liked it, you know.
Yeah, my sister saw that with her kids. And she didn't tell me how it was. I didn't ask her. How it was. I think she said it was cute. And then Karen, who hosted last week, she saw it with her family as well. And her niece, I believe. Uh-huh. And she said it was also cute. I do want to see it. That's a movie I want to see.
I mean, as an adult, I don't know if you want to go in the theater by yourself trying to see Secret Life of Pets.
I saw the Lego movie by myself.
Okay.
So, I don't know. It's probably not the same thing, but I did see that movie by myself. But last night, I went to see the movie version of the graphic novel Batman the Killing Joke. Now, you know I'm a big Batman fan.
Yes, I know that.
And this was a two-night event. It was last night and tonight. Okay. The movie's coming out on Blu-ray next month. It's a straight to, but they were showing it for two nights in the theatrical release. And they showed the movie last night. I saw it in Farmingdale. They showed it at a bunch of other theaters around the area. And I have to say, now, you don't know the story, but the story's very dark. This story particularly is very dark. And I don't know if you know the origin of the character, but you know who the Joker is, obviously.
Yes, yes.
This tries to explain how he became the Joker.
Oh, okay.
And they show him now, but they also show like flashback scenes of him mm-hmm. when he was becoming, what made him become the Joker. And I had read the comic years ago, and I actually just read it again this past week to refresh it in my mind because I wanted to have it. But the other thing was they added... The comic itself probably would have covered about an hour, and that wasn't long enough to have as a movie. So they added an extra 35 minutes to the movie, and Batgirl's in this comic, and they added an extra half hour and explained her background and her impact in the story. And there were a couple things that happened in it that it kind of kicked off some controversy. Like, there was some controversy when people started to see this. People started to get pre-screenings before these past 2 days. Uh-huh. Because there's a scene in the movie. I'm spoiling it for anyone, but I don't know. If you read the comic, you know the scene. Where what happens is that she opens the door and the Joker shoots her in her side.
Okay.
Right? And she's laying on the floor and the Joker's looking over her. And he says something to her and she looks up back and she says, like, why did you do this? And he makes a comment. And then he unbuttons one of the buttons on her shirt. Insinuating uh-huh. that he raped her.
Oh.
So a lot of people saw that and they're like, oh, you know, you shouldn't be doing that. It's technically a cartoon. Because it's an animated film. So right, like it's technically a cartoon.
But is it rated?
It is rated. It was rated R.
So.
But a lot of people are like, oh, you're not, you know, that's not right. You shouldn't, you know.
Yeah, we have a lot of people that complain about everything.
Right. Like, I think... I mean, people need to calm down a little bit.
Yeah. If it's rated, I have no problem. Like, I don't expect them to show that in Secret Life of Pets.
Right.
Because that's a kid's movie. But
right.
If a movie's rated R, then I don't know what...
Yeah, I mean, there's no... I mean, this is the first movie that they have nudity in it. Like, the first animated film I've seen.
Uh-huh.
With that kind of... those kind of scenes, especially in a Batman film. So, yeah, it was... That caused a lot of controversy, and I agree with you. I think, you know, we're getting to a point now where it's a story. It's, you know, stop being so sensitive. It's a story.
Even though it's animated, happen. Yeah.
it's a terrible side, but they're like, oh, once again, you're showing a female in a weakness position, and you know, the damsel in distress type deal. Earlier in the movie, though, there's also a scene where she has sex with Batman.
Oh.
Yeah. You don't see that. It's just kind of hinted at, and then the cutscene. But that was also another controversy, but for a different reason, because in the comic book lore, Batgirl is considered a lot younger than him. So that was the other controversy, like, oh, they shouldn't. And it's not part of the original comic.
Is she much younger than him?
She's got a job. She's, you know, she's a librarian. She's not in college, or, you know, she's not a teenager. She's young, but, and he's a lot older. But to me, people make a big deal about that. They're more concerned, like, oh, this is putting out, it wasn't part of the original story. It wasn't.
Okay.
So people were upset about that.
I know how, what do you call comic book freaks? What do you call yourselves?
Fanboys?
I know how you guys are. So maybe, you know, they wanted it to be,
I was fine
very
with it.
Loyal to the storyline.
Right. A lot of people are like that. A lot of people are like, oh, you shouldn't differ from.
But, you know, to be honest, I'm like that with books.
Right.
I always prefer to read a book before I see a movie. Because a lot of times the movie just does the book no justice.
There are some times where the changes they make I'm okay with. Like, I don't get upset with after I read a book and I say, oh. There are times where it's okay, but there are times where I'm like, yeah, that doesn't have no sense like that. Make no sense.
I guess maybe because I'm not a screenwriter or whatever, sometimes I'm just reading the book expecting it to be like the book when I'm watching a movie. But I guess in reality, the books are like, how many chapters long? You can't get everything
And you have
is.
Right. Yeah. There's artistic license in films. So, you're right. There's some things that just don't translate well to screen.
Right.
So you might take that out.
Yeah. Yeah. Because when you're reading, you're using your imagination.
Right.
And, you know, sometimes it's not easy to just put that on.
Right. Or it's illegal. Like, some things in books are really risque. You can't really do that on screen without maybe making it a NC-17 type of rating, and then nobody wants to see it.
Okay.
So, yeah. So sometimes you have those scenarios. But that's like Game of Thrones. In the books, the kids are much younger. Like, the kids are not adults.
Oh.
They're teens and younger.
Oh.
So,
see, I didn't know that because I didn't read a book.
So a lot of that, and we all love Game of Thrones. I don't know anyone who's watched it who hasn't liked the show. But, yeah, when you know, there's a lot of artistic license taken because, I mean, if they showed some of the things in Game of Thrones happening with kids, forget it.
Yes.
And there'd be boycotts and,
yeah.
Yeah, it'd be child porn almost. And we know that's not allowed.
Well, not to go off, it's not off topic, but I don't know if you remember, when I was a child, they had a movie, a TV show. It was a miniseries. It was called Shaka Zulu.
I do remember it.
That's on Netflix now.
Right.
And I'm watching it, and I'm happy I get to watch it, because I remember it in Jamaica when it came out, when I was a child and it came out, they put ratings on it, and then they started showing it in the nights.
Right.
Because people were complaining.
Yeah.
Because the African ladies in the movie, they had no bras on or tops on.
Right.
So I didn't really get to watch it as a child because I was sent to my bed because it's an adult movie. So now I'm adult TV show. So now I'm happy I'm getting to watch it again. Well, not really again, because I did try to watch it before, but it wasn't allowed. So I'm glad Netflix put that on.
Right.
I don't know where they dug it up from, but I was so happy that I started watching it this weekend. I have a few more episodes to watch.
I remember when it was on. that at that time, I wasn't interested in it. I was interested in other things. But I could take a look at it now. I'm sure I wouldn't. I'm sure I'd probably
like it. I mean, when you look at it now and see how far, you know, filmmaking and TV shows and stuff have come, it's really good because, you know, I don't know what you call it. Cinematography and all that. You see the big difference.
Oh, okay. There's one more thing I need to say. When I went to see Star Trek this weekend, one of the previews was for the movie Ben-Hur. Have you seen Ben-Hur? It's a classic. I think Charlton Heston, or maybe might not be Charlton Heston. Could be
I think I saw the original. It wasn't in black and white.
Could be Kirk Douglas.
Wasn't it in black and white?
No, it was color, I think.
Well, I don't know then. I'm thinking I watched it a long time ago and I cannot remember.
It's a but it's one of those classic films like that you shouldn't touch. It would be kind of be like remaking the Ten Commandments. You just don't touch those films in my eyes. And I saw the preview for it and the whole time I'm like, what the hell? Why are you doing this to this movie that... It's an iconic film. It's a classic film.
Uh-huh.
And it just, there's no purpose in it being made redone. Like, I don't know.
I find that a lot of movies and TV shows are being redone. Because remember Roots? That was a big thing, too.
Yes, that was redone.
Nobody wanted it to be. Yeah. I haven't seen the new one, so I can't comment and say, oh, it's not good. But, you know, a lot of people were upset. They didn't want it to be.
They definitely were. I remember, yes.
Show the old one. But I mean, I guess I'm gonna at some point I'll watch it and I'll see. But
right, do you have any desire to see the new Ghostbusters film?
No. I used to watch Ghostbusters as a child on TV.
Right. They used to have the cartoon.
It was the cartoon and stuff. But no, I didn't. Was it good? Did you see?
I didn't see it.
Okay.
But I've heard good things from people. Like, people I respect who watch movies.
Okay.
So, I didn't want to see it at all, but now I'm like, maybe I'll give it a shot.
Okay.
Maybe I'll be it'll be one of those things where I just go sneak away and watch it. And then talk about it when I come back. But no, yeah, that's been my past week.
Okay.
So, coming full circle back to the original topic that we went off on. But yeah, that was my week. Mm-hmm. And, like I said, tomorrow night's my MRI, so hopefully I get some kind of news and I have a plan so I can take care of this because it's annoying and I don't want to deal with it anymore. I don't want to talk too much about politics tonight.
Oh, thank you. I'm so...
The Democratic National Convention is going on right now.
Yes, yes.
And today was the official nomination of Hillary Clinton as the Democratic candidate for president.
Okay.
Now, I posted on Facebook...
Mm-hmm.
Something that said it's a big moment for women, you know, Hillary Clinton being nominated. She's the first nominee in our country's history.
It's historic. It's historic.
I am not a fan of hers. Mm-hmm. I don't like her for a number of reasons, but it is historic. It's an historic event.
Yes.
It's an historic thing that happened, and it should be recognized as such.
It should, yeah. And I mean, it will go down in the history books, you know.
Right. Oh, definitely. And if she wins, she'll be the first female president. Right. So that will be, an even bigger step. And, you know, again, she's a very polarizing figure.
Mm-hmm.
And for me as well, I wish I had a better choice. Let me put it this way. I wish I had a better choice who I thought could win.
Okay.
Because there are other choices out there. You have Gary Johnson in the Libertarian camp. You have Jill Stein in the Green Party. So there are other choices out there that you could vote for and throw your support behind. But I don't think they have a shot to win.
No.
And we know how I feel about Donald Trump. I know how about you feel about Donald Trump. So that's where we're at with that. But again, congratulations to Hillary Clinton and women of America. This should be a proud moment. No matter how you feel about her, it should be a proud moment.
It definitely should be because, I mean, this country is how many years old? Hundreds of years old.
Yeah.
I don't know specifically how many years. So, and this for her to be the first female nominee of the
major
political party, that is amazing.
It is.
And whether or not you're Republican or Democrat, you know, your daughters or, you know, your granddaughters, they should look at this and be like, okay, I can do this. This is not out of, the scope of what I will be able to do when I become an adult.
Right.
You know.
So, yeah. So, again, congratulations to her. And that's all I really wanted to say. I mean, there's other things that are going on, but
next week is your big political show. I know.
Yes, our former coworker who now lives in North Carolina, he is going to be joining me on the show remotely. Mm-hmm. He'll be calling in, and we'll be having a political show pretty much. We're going to go over both conventions, and we're going to discuss, the ins and outs and what we thought were good, what we thought were bad. We're going to try and be as nonpartisan as possible because I want to be able to give a fair reading to both sides. There were some good moments in the Republican one. I'm not going to sit here and tell you there aren't. And there were some bad points. And there have been some bad points in the Democratic one.
Yeah, it started off rough, but hopefully.
Yeah, so. But I also want to give a shout out to Bernie Sanders, who handled this situation probably as best as you could.
Yes.
He ran a great campaign. He clearly obviously wanted the nomination. I watched his speech last night. You could tell, people were like, oh, you didn't see a conflict. I did. I could tell. He was a little conflicted saying that speech. But bottom line is he lost. Mm-hmm. He didn't, even if people want to talk about controversies and scandals, she won more votes overall, so he lost. And today I believe he was the last person to speak and not giving her the full nomination. Okay. And that, again, was probably torturous for him to do. But he, like I said, he ran a great campaign. He did push a lot of things from his agenda into the platform.
Right.
So hopefully those things will get enacted if Hillary wins the presidency. And then we can see what happens. But no matter what happens with regards to the election, he has started a political movement that probably is going to continue now going forward.
Yes.
And that's something he should be proud of.
He should. Because, you know, initially, I'll be honest, I was kind of leaning toward him. But, you know, he didn't win.
I know. So, yeah. So, again, that's all the politics I'm going to talk about tonight. No more. I know we all know I could get into it and talk for hours, but I'm not going to do
that.
Yes. I'm currently losing family members as I speak on Facebook, I think. So,
I'm sure that's not true.
It's okay. I love them anyway. It's fine. I'm losing family and friends, but it's fine. It's you know, part of the job, part of the deal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're all passionate about what we believe in, and you know, we all come from passionate people. My parents were very passionate people, so you know, me and my sisters don't agree on a lot. this election in particular. So yeah, but in other news, let's talk about other news. And something sad happened. A fake countrywoman of yours.
Oh my God.
I shouldn't say that. But was Miss Cleo played in Jamaica? Did you guys ever see her down there on TV?
We saw her. We had cable TV.
I don't know what you get.
Calm enough. And the only people she fooled were Americans. We all knew she was not Jamaican.
She didn't fool us for long. Like, we didn't, it wasn't something that we were fooled on long. Because after a while, you're like, yeah, no, that doesn't sound too Jamaican.
Yeah, because I read the article that you sent about her death. I mean, rest in peace, Miss Cleo. But, you know, the article said, oh, she nailed the accent. Right. She did not nail it. She did not. It was as fake can be. We all knew she was not Jamaican.
Right. She coined the term Jafakin.
Definitely.
She was the inspiration behind that term.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, but it was sad that she passed from cancer.
Yeah.
So, you know, they said she was up until the end that she was fighting and she was strong and positive. And regardless of how she came to fame and...
Yeah, you know, that's a terrible disease. It's sad when, you know, somebody loses their life, and, you know, especially to cancer. I mean, I lost an aunt to cancer.
Right.
It's, you know, it's painful for them. You know, it's a lot of, they go through a lot. I mean, congrats to the people who overcome cancer.
Yes.
But, you know, a lot of people are dying from cancer. And I mean, I don't know. There seems to be no end in sight, because I know they have all these people that are doing research for cures and stuff, but I mean, I don't know. It is what it is.
Yeah, no, it's, again, cancer is a terrible disease. It's such a, I mean, all diseases are bad, but cancer, I know. So rest in peace, Miss Cleo. I hope you have a good psychic network up in heaven.
I wonder if she saw this one coming. You think she saw it coming? I don't know. Not to make fun of her death.
Too soon, Renee. Too soon. Well, she read the cards. She did the tarot cards. So I don't know how that worked. I know nothing about being a psychic or... you might
I have never been to a psychic. I will never go to a psychic. You know, let my life just play out and, you know, let me be surprised. I don't want to know.
Well, in some religions, it's frowned upon. I know that. Mine, Catholicism being one of them. You're not supposed to go to psychics and things like that.
Okay.
So, but yes, again, rest in peace, Miss Cleo. So, in other news, my man, Dr. Dre, this was a bizarre story that I read, and I just wanted to think to discuss it tonight. He was handcuffed and arrested on a citizen's arrest yesterday. Someone saw him brandishing a gun.
He did not brandish a
right,
gun.
Right, he didn't. But someone said that they saw him doing it.
But this is how, and yes. This story got me upset.
Okay, speak.
Because this is how black men get killed all the time over overzealous people who make reports that are so untrue.
Right.
He, according to the story, and I'm hoping that is correct.
Right.
And this is this is on in Rolling Stone. We have to give credit to where the story came from.
Yes, we read it in Rolling Stone.
In Rolling Stone. So they're saying the man was blocking his driveway.
Right.
So he asked him to move, and then they started cursing or whatever. The man,
right.
He took out his phone to videotape the man, and then the man accused him of having a gun.
Right.
The police came, they searched him. They didn't find any gun.
No. They said when they arrived, he was briefly handcuffed and searched, but the officers didn't find anything. So, but the guy, the motorist, whose his name isn't in the report, shockingly enough. The motorist, however, insisted on making a citizen's arrest and filled out a report detailing his allegations.
But how does he make a citizen arrest if the police are there? I do not understand how a citizen
arrest... Because the police didn't want to arrest him.
So how is he going to make a citizen's arrest?
Well, he says arrest them.
He tells the police to arrest him?
Yeah, because he wants it on record.
Okay, and did
But they? Like you said, they handcuffed him and didn't find a gun... So I don't know what's going to happen here.
It probably will be thrown out.
Yes, and it should be.
It should be. But I'm just saying, people need to be careful about, you know, what they're calling and reporting to the police.
Definitely. No, you're right.
Because that's dangerous.
It's very dangerous. I mean, this is Dr. Dre. I'm sure the police probably knew who he was. You know, you never know, but once they pulled up and saw him, they're probably like, oh, that's Dr. Dre. And,
right.
You know, and although his past has problems with the law, as we've mm-hmm. seen, we saw it in Straight Outta Compton, you listen to his music and you know where he's come from. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's been clean for years.
Right.
Like nothing. You've heard nothing about him. So, yeah, I don't know, but you're right. Maybe the guy knew who he was too, and he's like, "Oh, I'm gonna get Dr. Dre arrested."
Yeah, you know, some people they see the celebrities, they wanna be famous, they wanna get their 15 minutes off of somebody else's fame. So that's probably what it is about.
Yeah, Dre. I'm a Dre fan, by the way. I've been for years, so gotta give a shout out to Dre. I'm glad nothing bad happened. With the climate and everything right now, it would have been bad.
Yes.
Bad story. So there was some more. There's more sad news. I'm going to go through the sad news first. I didn't even hear about this, which is crazy. Did you hear about the nightclub shooting in Florida? The other one?
Yes, I heard about it. Actually, I heard about it this morning when I was, you know, getting ready for work.
Right.
I was listening to the news.
I hadn't heard about it at all. And normally I always see this stuff. But it was at a teen event at a club called Club Blue in Fort Myers, Florida.
Yes.
And apparently the gunman opened fire early Monday morning. He took down at least 16 victims and two of who died.
Right.
The club said it had security at the event, and the police say the gunmen were not kids at the event.
Yeah, and I don't know. They didn't catch them, so
no.
We don't know what the motive is.
No, 3 people were captured while fleeing the scene, but police have not said for sure if they're the gunmen.
Right.
They're being detained, but there's nothing. This is according to TMZ. I'm reading from TMZ. So, yeah.
It's sad when, you know, your kids aren't even safe just going to a teen party.
Right, and again, another week, another shooting.
Yeah. It's the summertime, you know, kids want to go out, they want to have fun, but I don't know, if I were a parent, I'm going to be honest. I think my child would be inside all the time, which is what they want. And they probably, you know, would be happy with that. But I don't know.
I'm torn on the issue. Like I said, I always say you can never do that because you can't stop living your life because that's what they want. Mm-hmm. And, you know, these kids have to live and we all have to live and try it. But in this case, we have no idea what the motivation was behind it yet. We don't know anything about the backstory except that this happened. But I was surprised obviously the conventions are going on so mm-hmm. politics are in the forefront. But I'm surprised it didn't seem to pick up as much steam as...
Well, as I told you, I heard they reported on it multiple times this morning when I was, you know, watching the news.
So. Right.
I'm not really sure where you're watching your news.
No, I didn't. Again, like normally I'll check my phone. Someone will post something on Facebook about it, or I'll be on my Twitter feed. I'll be reading that, something going on. By the way, if anyone wants to give us a call in and contribute to the show, you can call us at 516-945-9099. Come in and join the conversation. If you have a topic you want to discuss and throw at us, I'll be happy to discuss that as well. Whatever you want to do.
Is there a call coming in?
Huh?
Is there a call coming in?
Oh, damn.
Hello, caller. What's your name? Where are you calling from? Hello? Hello.
Shout out to Eric Holzman.
Who was that?
Where are you pocketing that?
Okay, whoever did that, really? You know, don't waste my time with that crap, man. If you're going to call in and ask something, talk about something, but don't do that. But thanks for calling anyway. And thanks for watching. So, wow, that was weird. Anyway, I wonder who that was. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to see if I can piece the voice. I can't right now. Don't know who that was. Anyway. All right. So, the MTV Video Music Awards are next month, I believe. Yeah, right? They're in August usually, so yeah.
Okay.
And today, the nominees were announced for the awards. Now, I don't watch videos like I used to.
Neither do I.
So this is always like a weird thing for, you know, me to talk about. But I have seen a couple of these that are on the list.
Mm-hmm.
For Video of the Year, which is the big prize of the night, we have Adele with Hello, Beyonce with Formation, Drake with Hotline Bling, Justin Bieber with Sorry, and Kanye West with Famous. Have you seen any of those videos?
I have seen Hello and I've seen Formation.
Have you seen Famous?
No, I do not watch Kanye West.
Well, you in LA can bond later over that because he doesn't as well. He doesn't,
I don't really watch music videos, to be honest. When I'm home, if I'm not watching Discovery ID, I'm watching some kind of comedy. But so no.
Yeah, I obviously don't watch videos as much as I did when I was younger. It's just part of growing up, I think.
Yeah, when I was younger, I remember BET used to show a lot of videos, but I don't think they do anymore.
Did you watch Midnight Love? BET used to have Midnight Love.
Was that the one with the...
It was all the R&B
videos?
Songs.
Oh, okay, no.
At midnight to 12:30.
No, I remember they had a segment on BET. When I caught it once, it was all the booty clapping videos.
BET After Dark.
What was it?
BET After Dark.
I don't know what it was. I saw that
one. Yo, that was the best. If you were a rap fan in the 90s and the early 2000s and you wanted to watch the raw uncut videos, stayed up and you watched BET After Dark.
Yeah, I saw it once. I was like, what is this?
Caller, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Donald Trump for president.
Okay.
Yes, it definitely is.
That's why I'm not taking another call from that person. I don't know who that was, but thank you. Thank you for calling in. Yeah, so of the videos that I mentioned, mm-hmm. I've seen Hello. I've seen Formation. Actually, I've seen all of these now that I think about it.
Right.
The best one to me was Famous. Simply because, I don't like Kanye. I'm not a big fan. But the video itself, that's the one where he was laying in bed with all the celebrities.
I saw a picture on the internet with some naked celebrities in a big bed. It was something to do with Kanye.
Yes.
I skipped over that because I do not read anything that concerns Kanye West or his wife or her family. I'm not interested.
Right.
But I did see that picture. So I guess that's a part of the video. I don't know.
Yeah, no, that's basically the video.
Okay.
Yeah, but just because he did that and it was all of those they were wax figures of all those people.
Uh-huh.
I think it's a good visual, and I think that's the video I would choose for. All the other ones were kind of, Formation was good, but all the other ones were kind of blah, and wouldn't watch an Adele video and be like, ooh, that was a good video. I just like hearing her sing.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't need to watch her. I just like hearing her voice.
Okay.
But all the other ones, again, Hotline Bling, Drake, yeah, whatever.
I liked Formation. I thought it was very artistic.
Oh, it was. It definitely was.
I think that it's different. I mean, I guess you'd say that The Famous was different too, but I like Formation. But
right.
I haven't seen the others, so I can't give an unbiased opinion on, you know, which one I think should win.
And this is always weird to me. So Formation was nominated for Video of the Year. Mm-hmm. But then you go to Best Female Video. Beyonce's in it again, but not for that same song. She's in for Hold Up, which I haven't seen. Did you see that? I didn't see it.
Well, I think it's Hold Up. Yeah, that's the reggae. That's the one, I think, with the reggae vibe.
Right.
Right?
I know the song.
Because I watched Lemonade. That's what it was called, right?
Right,
I watched it. I like that whole thing.
Right.
So if that part of the video is what they're talking about,
mm-hmm.
that was good too.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But see, Adele was Hello Again for the Best Female. But Beyonce wasn't for Formation.
But it wasn't for Formation.
So I don't know how the committees with the award shows.
Yeah, you have to speak with them about that.
They always kind of shock me when they do this stuff. I'm like, you have this in one, but then in the other, it's something completely different.
Right,
so
right.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. But Sia for Cheap Thrills, Ariana Grande for Into You, and Rihanna and Drake for Work.
Well, Work, you know.
I'm gonna say
Work should win this one.
Of all of those, I would pick that as well. That would be my choice for the video.
You know, she had on her little Rasta colors and everything. So let's go with Work on that one.
Right. Yes. And the male video, again, we have Drake for Hotline Bling. Bryson Tiller for Don't. Do you like Bryson Tiller?
Is he that young singer guy?
Yes. Yes, he's a singer.
I'm going to be honest.
He's got a really good voice.
I'm not up to date with
Well, you listen to R&B, so that's why I was asking.
Yeah, but sometimes I listen to the songs, but I don't even know who sings.
Right. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I don't know who the singers are.
The Weeknd's nominated for Can't Feel My Face. Kanye West again for Famous.
Mm-hmm.
And then Calvin Harris with Rihanna for This Is What You Came For. I like the song. I've just never seen the video. I don't know.
Okay.
All right. So, yeah. So, you know, there's more videos here that were nominated for Best New Artist. There's five people. I only have heard of two of them. She's showing my age. Well, three, actually.
Mm-hmm.
One of them is the band with the Jonas Brother. They have that song, Cake by the Water. I don't know if you know it.
Maybe. If I hear it, I'll know it.
Have you heard it?
I think so.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They do that song. But again, it's in August, I want to say. Yes, August 28th. It's mm-hmm. back in Madison Square Garden. I remember when it was in Miami for a couple years.
I probably wasn't here yet. I don't know.
But they did bring up for the long form video, which is what you were talking about, and Lemonade is nominated for that.
Oh, Lemonade was very good. I like Beyonce. I'm not a big Beyonce fan. There are songs that she puts out that I like.
Right.
But I watched it and I was intrigued. You know, I liked the whole thing. I liked how it was set up. I liked the fact that she moved, the way it started, the way it ended, you
right.
know, the whole thing with redemption, forgiveness, all of it. I liked it.
Okay. Yeah, you know what? A little of her now goes a long way with me. We've discussed this before. Again, I remember when she started with Destiny's Child, so she's been around for a really long time. And although I think artistically she's grown a lot since then, and she's pushed more envelopes.
She has started to.
Yeah, she definitely has, and which is, as an artist, that's what you want to see.
Yes.
When someone gets to that point, because you don't want to be stale. But, right. You know, no one wants to hear the same thing over and over again. So, but for me, she just kind of, I don't know. I'm kind of like, you know what? Go away for a while. Maybe she went away for a few years and then came back.
But wasn't she away for a good, because before Lemonade, I mean, what did she put out before that?
But the thing with her is she doesn't have to be her album. She might be featured on something, so you hear her. She might be somewhere else.
Yeah, she has
to
make her money, Eric.
Yeah,
come
because
on.
She's really hurting for it. She really needs money. I mean, God. I think she was,
why
after
are you
Taylor Swift,
on
I think.
The young lady?
I'm not
she's
hating.
Making
no, no.
Money.
This is not hate. It's not hate. I do not hate her. She's just to the point now, like every artist, this happens with every artist. They become oversaturated to me, and then I don't want to hear them anymore.
But you know what the greatest thing about this thing is?
What?
Choice. You can choose not to listen to her, but her fans want her.
Right.
If you hear her on the radio, you can switch the dial. Or whatever you do.
Well, of course.
Right?
I'm not talking about everybody else. I'm talking about my opinion. This is my opinion.
Why are you getting annoyed with the poor girl trying to make some money?
Who said I'm annoyed? I'm not annoyed. I just want her to go away. I'm tired of...
Why do you want her to go away? Her fans love her.
Because let someone else... You know what?
Love her.
Rihanna too. Go. Go take a break.
But you know what? Rihanna has put out an album. I think maybe it's... Probably the biggest break between albums is probably like a year or two.
Yes.
But she said when she came out her first album, something about the sun, I can't remember. Since that, she put out an album every year,
yeah,
back to back for like 7 years.
I know, she needs to calm
straight
down.
Straight. I need, like that. She's making her money. She's worth, they just said she's worth over $75 million or something like that.
Okay, so why does she need to make more?
What? Continue making the money. That's what I say.
No, I don't know. But she's another one that, and we all know my favorite, Taylor Swift. Just,
I'm not going to discuss Taylor Swift today.
Yo, there was a story about her that I deliberately went over because I said we're not talking Taylor Swift.
I think
Swift.
You secretly have a crush on
I
Taylor
don't.
Swift.
I don't. Not even a little bit. There's nothing about her that I like. Nothing. Mm-hmm. Like, literally zero. I don't diminish. I don't say. She writes very good songs for her demographic. It's all about breakups and
makeup.
I hate ex-boyfriends, and a lot of young girls listen to her. So go ahead. I have no problem with her. Me personally, get away from me.
Okay.
Just, I don't want to hear you. I don't want to hear you talk. Nothing. So, but yeah. But back to the VMAs. They I think Adele, or maybe it was Drake. I don't
has
know.
The most nominations.
Yes. I believe.
Okay.
So, are you going to watch? Will you watch?
I generally don't watch. I'm going to be honest.
Not even for the performances?
Not even.
No?
No.
If Tessa and Chin was on, you'd watch.
If Tessa and Chin was on, I would definitely watch.
Well, we know that's not happening anytime soon.
What? She will be on soon.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to hold my breath
Big
on that
up
one.
Tessa and Chin.
Yes.
Best vocalist ever.
Ever?
Ever.
Ever, ever?
Ever.
Unbelievable. I don't know what's happening to my show tonight. You can take an order. So good luck to all the nominees. I don't really mean that, but good luck to all the nominees because you're all rich.
It's
anyway.
An honor just to be nominated.
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. That's what you say before you lose. But then when you win, you're like, yes. You're all happy. You don't want to be.
Suckers.
No one who does
won.
That. That is the biggest crock when people say that. You know that?
No, but you know what? I think it's. I don't think so. Because
yes,
in
it
certain
is.
Things, like even in a best actor category in the Oscars or something, you know, that adds to your resume if you get an Oscar nomination. So to be nominated is really an honor.
No, I'm not saying it's not an honor. I'm just saying it's a crock of crap when they say it's just an honor to be nominated. You want to win. Everyone wants to win. You don't think all these people
want
to win.
I'm sure they want to win.
Now, there's two times when you know you're just happy to be nominated. And these are the two times. It never fails if you're up for an Oscar, mm-hmm, and Meryl Streep is in your category. She's
no,
winning.
No, but the
she's winning.
No.
Just
no, Eric. Statistically, she has lost more than
nope.
anybody
uh-uh.
because she has been nominated
nope.
more than anybody.
Nope, I'm sorry. She has like 12 awards, some crazy number like
but
that.
But because of the number of times that they have nominated her,
look,
she has lost more Oscar nominations than any other actor or actress because she has been nominated.
I'm sorry.
So many times.
If you are in a category with her, you are losing. Just say you're happy to be nominated and continue walking because you're not going to win.
But she's
that's
an amazing actress.
Oh, she is.
She's an amazing
she
actress.
She is.
She deserves used to irritate most me. Of them.
No, she does. She used to irritate me, but as I got older, I appreciate her now
yes.
more than I did. The other one, Daniel Day-Lewis. If he's nominated as a male,
he's just good too.
Be happy to be nominated to other people because he's winning. He's going to get the award. Don't cry.
He's a good actor too.
And they all know that too. Like if I was it, I'd be like, damn. This dude
but
again.
But I'm telling you, Meryl Streep has lost. If you Google it.
Oh no, I mean, I know she's lost.
So many times.
But that's like few and far between.
She has lost more than any other actress.
That's just ridiculous. But you know, if she does a movie, she's getting nominated. It could be the biggest crap movie ever made.
And she's
getting a nomination. It just happens. That's how it goes. So yeah, so those are the times where if I was an actor and I have an actress, Meryl mm-hmm. Streep, and an actor, Daniel Day-Lewis, yeah, I'd just be like, you know what? I would say I'm just happy to be nominated because I would mean it.
I mean, I lost faith in the Oscars a long time ago. I don't even want to get into that.
Here we go.
Years ago, I remember American Beauty, Kevin Spacey, and The Hurricane.
Awesome movie.
Denzel Washington. I watched Denzel Washington in a Hurricane. I'm like, he has to be the winner of the Oscars.
Why?
For that. He was amazing.
He was good.
He wasn't good. He was great.
He was good.
He was great. Did you watch The Hurricane?
Yes. I've seen the movie.
He was great.
He was.
And I watched America. And when they gave that Oscar to Kevin Spacey, I was like, I'm done with the Oscars.
It's a little haterism in your game.
I wash my hands. I'm like, no.
Got a little hateration going on.
No.
Yeah, you do.
No.
You do.
No. Did you see the
Hurricane? Wait a minute. Hold on. Hold on. Let me just say this. You don't think Kevin Spacey was equally as good?
No.
Okay.
I'm not saying Kevin Spacey's not a good actor. Please do not get me wrong, because I like him.
Right.
I saw him in Paid Forward. I don't know. I think I've told you about it before. I don't know if you've ever seen it with the young kid. I can't remember his name.
Haley Joel Osment?
Yes. He's an amazing actor.
Who's not young anymore, but go ahead.
Not the kid.
No, I know.
Kevin Spacey.
Yeah.
But when I saw American Beauty and compared it to Denzel Washington's performance in Hurricane.
Right.
He should not have won. That's you just the point. I was basing it on the performances that they were nominated for.
But you know what?
For.
And I'll say this. Denzel is... He's one of the best actors alive right now. And he's been nominated a lot too. And he has won. So maybe the Academy threw Kevin Spacey a bone. What's the problem?
No. Up until that point, Denzel Washington had not won anything.
Yes, he won for Glory many years ago. Best Supporting
Actor.
That
was supporting. That wasn't best
so?
Actor.
So? Oh, wait a minute. So that doesn't count.
That's different.
How is it different?
It is different. Best Supporting is different from Best Actor.
It's still giving. You're still on. You're giving.
And we're not into the
recognition.
They should have been in the business of throwing people bones.
They do it all the time.
They threw him a bone the year after when they gave him
for training day. But he was great in
but
that.
But he wasn't half as good in Training Day as he was in
but
the
Renee,
Hurricane.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe the Academy is like, you know what? Kevin Spacey is a good actor. He's not Denzel Washington. Denzel will be back here again. He was the next year.
I won't
but
get
the same
into
thing
why
with Leonardo
he didn't
DiCaprio.
Win. I will not get into why he
no,
didn't
see,
win.
No.
Okay.
There are times where I will give you that, the reason you're thinking, and you can say it if you want, because that's fine with me.
I'm not saying anything.
There are times I will give you that. But in this instance, I do not think that was the case.
Well, I was very hurt that year, and I'm so and then since then, my point is I don't trust the Oscars anymore. They're like, whatever.
So you were upset Leonardo DiCaprio won last year?
I don't know what happened last year.
For best actor?
I don't know what happened. I told you, I'm not into the Oscars that much anymore.
Okay. What about the
I only read about it after.
What about the Golden Globes?
No, I'm not into that either.
No? Why?
I don't know. Award shows are boring.
They are. They are. But I mean, that's the recognition. Like, I don't watch all of them. And when I do watch them, I just kind of skip around for the awards I want to see. Mm-hmm. And that's it. But doing this now... It's something that I keep an eye on because it's something I can discuss. A lot of people do watch it. Mm-hmm. It is something that people, you know.
I mean, after the fact, I will watch some of the speeches, like, you know, when Lupita won for...
Right.
Was it Best Supporting that she won?
Yeah, for 12 Years
a Slave. Yeah, her speech was amazing. Right. I watched her speech. You know, there's some others that I'll watch the speeches after, but to sit and watch the whole show, it's not my thing.
My problem with... the problem I have with the Oscars is they always recognize artsy films, and they never recognize the big budget blockbuster movies. Like, you can, just because a movie is about a superhero doesn't mean it wasn't the best movie that year. That's okay. The thing that bothers me about those shows. It's like you have to either be about some cause or, you know, a historical piece, something like that, to get nominated for Best Picture. No, not just get nominated, but win for Best Picture.
Oh, yeah? I don't know what they are.
Like, you're not...
Past nominees, I can't remember, so I can't even...
And that's my problem. And, of course, like, with the Oscars, and I could say this, and we will, it's politics. Again, it's something that's very political. They, you know, it's just... You have people voting for these awards on these people that, you know, they might want in a film, or they want, you know...
Mm-hmm.
So they vote them as the... So, again, it's political just like everything else. But that's something that always bothered me about the Oscars. Mm-hmm. I don't know how we got on this. Oh, we were talking about the VMAs. And,
then we went straight. We segued all the way over to the Oscars.
Went all the way left. And we'll come back a little bit. So, yeah, I will probably watch the VMAs.
Okay.
I'll probably watch them just for the performances. Even though now when I watch it, I'm like, why am I watching this? I have no idea why. But
you could tune into VH1 Soul or one of those channels
ahead
of time just to see the video so you'll know what they're talking about.
Yeah, no, I'm not going to watch the video.
Are you going to YouTube?
I would rather just see them, like the people perform. The only thing I probably won't watch is whoever does the rap act now, unless it's like Kendrick Lamar or someone I like,
because
I'm not watching that nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So the VMAs. That's that. All right. In more entertainment news, our friend Justin Timberlake was at a... He is a friend, by the way, personal friend of mine and Renee's.
Yes. Big up, Justin. Whoever you stand up, just big up yourself. You
know, yes. Support. Call me. We got to discuss that thing. You know. So he was... on Saturday... He was at the American Century Celebrity Pro-Am Golf Tournament in Lake Tahoe. And apparently, we saw the video. He was walking down whatever. I don't know where he was, but he was walking through the crowd. And someone... Now, see, they say slap, but it wasn't a slap.
No, I watched the video. There was no slap.
So someone tried to reach out and just touch him, which was creepy to begin with. But... but it was creepy to begin with. And... The guy touched him, and he turns around. He's like, well, why would you do that? And he walked off of security. Now, again, we saw the video.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't a slap.
No, it was a touch of, like...
Right. So Hollywood... I mean, the media, once again, sensationalizing something to be that something is not. But, I mean, people, keep your hands to yourself.
Yeah. People get overexcited when they see celebrities. They're just people. And you wouldn't want to be walking on the street and some stranger just starts touching your neck.
No.
So why would a celebrity want you to do that?
Right. And let's be honest, it's creepy. Some creepy stuff.
Remember there was some guy who tried to kiss Will Smith?
Yes.
Why? I don't...
Because these fans are nuts.
Yes.
These stalking fans.
And that's why they need bodyguards.
No, exactly. Like, hey, you don't know who's going to come at you just being a normal person.
Uh-huh.
So when you have fame and fortune and you walk in and people know who you are and they just want to be in your presence.
Uh-huh.
Most of the people, 99% of the people are just cool and want to
take a picture,
say hello. But that 1%.
Yes. The 1%ers.
You might turn around, get a knife in your stomach and...
But shout out to Rihanna. I remember years ago, I think, she was at a concert walking through the crowd and somebody was trying to grab... And she used her mic and slapped that from my...
I didn't see that.
Yes.
Did she really?
Yes. She's like, what is wrong with
you?
Because that's how they have to get... Because some of these fans, they don't know... They don't have any boundaries.
Nah, stand up for yourself.
But that wasn't a slap to all the media people who reported it. It was completely wrong. He touched him.
Right. It was. Yeah. You watch this thing, you're like, That's what people call a slap nowadays?
Yeah, that's not a slap.
Well, I've been slapped a few times. I wish it was like that. Because that, you know, that's something that I would be fine with. Like, oh, okay, just touch my face. That's fine. Mm-hmm. Okay, so Subway, former Subway spokesman and current pedophile, Jared Vogel, he has said, and his claims the secret clams installed in his home weren't meant to record child porn. That's what he said. And this is the this is not him actually. It's his ex CEO of his charity. His name is Russell Taylor, and he says that they weren't set up for that as well. Taylor is serving a 27-year sentence for child porn as part of this whole thing. And
so what did it it just happened to capture him having sex with a child?
That was my...
But it wasn't set up for child porn, so what? That makes it all better?
This is the type of thing, you just don't, just be quiet.
Yeah,
Let your lawyer speak for you. Don't say anything. Just be quiet, because, look,
These guys
are reprehensible. I hope whatever happens to them tenfold. I have no love lost for either one of them. Child porn and that kind of stuff is disgusting, terrible. But on the legal side of things, these guys have, you know, they have pending court cases. Just shut up. And if their lawyers aren't telling them to shut up, then fire the lawyer. Like, what do you... I don't know.
I don't know how he's planning to spin it. There's nothing that he... So what? It wasn't set up for that. That's what it caught, because that's what you're doing.
Right.
So...
Man, you know what? Every time I read one of these stories about these former... Like, these celebrities, I use that word term for him loosely. Mm-hmm. It's like... That's what these people really... That's who they really are. Like, what we see... It's so true. What we see of celebrities, I mean, is such a small percentage of what these people really are.
I've always said it. If I really like an entertainer, I don't want to meet that entertainer.
Right.
Because a lot of times, if I meet them on a bad day, that's going to spoil my image of them. And then it's going to ruin my whole enjoyment of whatever entertainment value they're bringing to me. So I prefer not to meet them.
Right.
You know, because... Let me see them on stage. Let me see them on screen. I'm fine with that. I don't need to be in their faces.
Right.
I don't need to say hi. I don't need to know them.
No, I agree. It
they don't need to be my friend.
No. I agree. But with the advent of social media and how much access we actually have to them now, and what they put themselves on Twitter and Snapchat and Instagram, begin to feel like you get to know these people. You know?
It's true.
And... You know, but again,
because I follow a few people that I like,
right?
And most of the people I like and I follow, I don't have a problem with them. But I'm hoping none of them put out anything that's gonna make me have to stop following them.
That's what you always hope. You always hope that the people that you like, the celebrities that you, well, I don't say look up to, but that you like, that they're normal people, and that, you know, that they're just happen to be successful at what they do.
But that's the point, though. They are normal. They're gonna have bad days. They're probably just, you know, every time you see a celebrity or an entertainer on the streets, you don't have to rush up to them, because they're going to have bad days where they just want to be alone. They don't want to deal with you.
Yeah.
You know?
Especially like Alec Baldwin and Russell Crowe. Leave those guys alone, please.
They're mean entertainers.
They just...
they don't like to be bothered.
Yeah. They're not stable when it comes to these... situations.
And especially the paparazzi, they don't make it any easier for them.
Oh, no. Paparazzi could... I understand. I mean, that's one of the great things about America. In this instance, with them, it's one of the terrible things at the same time.
Because
it's their right to do that, what they're doing. There's nothing that says they can't.
Right, the freedom to do it, yeah.
But they are relentless in invading these people's lives.
Yep. They will search through their garbage.
Yep.
They'll camp out at their houses. It's like living in a prison, if you can imagine. You can't do anything, go anywhere without being, you know, followed
recorded. And the largest stars, like Michael Jackson, who had to deal with it. And I mean, granted, he was weird and brought a lot of his stuff on himself. I'm not going to lie. But you can't do anything.
No. He wore masks to get out. He said that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, you know, give celebrities their space, too. They're people, too. Just a PSA for the day. All right, so I read this story, and once again, from our great, great friends in the state of Florida, because, and I lived there for 4 years, so I can make fun of them if I need to.
And I want to live there because I like the weather.
So, yeah, so this story was so bizarre. Anyway, I'm sorry, it wasn't Florida. I read the wrong story. This was Pennsylvania. My fault. Sorry, Florida. It wasn't you this time. So according to, I read this article in the Huffington Post, according to the Huffington Post, a Pennsylvania man is in jail on burglary charges, and he's now accused of using a human brain to get high. Okay. Mm-hmm. Joshua Long, that's this guy's name, he's 26. He was charged with abuse of a corpse after his aunt found the brain underneath the front porch of a vacant trailer in Penn Township. The brain was on display in a container, something like you might have seen in a museum. And apparently, this is something new that's happening. It's something called wet marijuana,
right,
where he was using the formaldehyde that was put in the brain as an additive to get high. Now, I'm gonna throw back to the old to the old Morphe A&G show with this question: was he black or was he white?
I'm gonna say he was white.
Yes, he was white. He was white.
Sorry.
Shout out to Morphe and A&G, by the way. They're doing their thing as always. You can,
yeah, big up to them.
Big up to both of them. You can find them if you go to their Instagram or their Facebook or their Snapchat, probably, and Twitter. If you do DJ Morphe or DJ A&G, you can find out what they're up to. Two of my friends, so look and see what they're up to. They're always DJing something or somewhere. But back to this story again. Yeah, so apparently he said he knew it was illegal to have the brain, mm-hmm, and he named it Freddy. Okay. So go ahead.
No, I'm just wondering how mundane, how sad is your life that you are willing to use, what is it, embalming fluid or whatever?
Yeah. I mean, mugshots are never good, but
increase the high.
I know. And they said that this is something that's potentially fatal. It's very carcinogenic.
Of course it is.
It could cause long-term health problems. So, yeah, I don't know. This guy's...
People say no to drugs.
Yeah, but I haven't heard of this wet marijuana phenomenon.
I never heard of it.
Something
I'd
never heard of
until I heard about this story. And,
you know, I don't have kids myself. I have nieces and nephews, but the stuff these kids have access to now, as opposed to when I was growing up or when you were growing up,
way more.
Yeah, scary.
Didn't they have in the city in Bronx? I think I can't. I don't want to mislead people, but. Didn't they have a story where they had the synthetic marijuana where a lot of people were just passing out in the...
Yes.
Was it in the Bronx or the city? I can't remember.
It was either the Bronx or Brooklyn.
It was a lot of them on the one day. So they're, and it was in the same area. Yes. So they're thinking they all got it from the same batch.
Right.
And people were just passing out.
Yep.
Almost dying.
Yeah. I remember the story. It was a couple weeks ago. Maybe a month ago.
Yeah. It wasn't
that long ago. Yeah, I mean, how high do you need to get?
I don't know.
My question.
I have to say, I've never smoked anything. I've never done any kind of drugs, so
I could ask someone.
It's not a feeling I know. Go ahead.
I could ask someone this question, but I won't. I'll keep it to myself. No, I don't want to put you on blast. It's fine. It's fine.
I do not know.
I don't do that stuff anymore.
Yes, this is true.
I'm willing to help others.
No, but seriously, how high do you need to get? Like, when is there a point where you're like, you know what? Sometimes this certain high is just too high, and I need to slow down. I need to bring myself back to the fold and come back to a little bit of normalcy. So yeah, so everyone, you know, when you fill out those organ donor cards on on your license and stuff, your brain might one day be someone's.
And I'm an organ donor. I put myself as an organ donor.
Yeah, so me too. I'm an organ donor as well.
That's scary. I'm hoping
it's
my
very
organs
scary.
Go to some good use.
It is very scary. Very scary. All right, so now I want to bring I want to bring us to another story that every 4 years we all know we have the Olympics.
Yes.
It's a celebration of sports. Right. The Summer Olympics and we have the Winter Olympics.
Right.
They're offset every 2 years now, so we have one every. But the Olympics are coming in Rio. Mm-hmm. They start next week. August 5th is the opening ceremonies, barring some crazy environmental disaster, which very well could be possible from all the stuff I'm reading. Now, the Soccer World Cup was 2 years ago, was in Rio as well.
Yes.
I don't remember hearing half the stuff about what I'm reading, and we'll get to it in a few minutes, about that as I'm hearing about this. Do you remember any, like, you follow soccer probably more than I do. So do you remember hearing anything about the venues or?
I don't remember. It was 2 years ago. I cannot remember. I don't think I heard anything.
Right. But apparently Rio's in bad shape. Like apparently.
Yes, I'm reading the stories and they're not ready for the Olympians. And remember, the Olympics is going to be way bigger than the football.
Oh, yeah.
World Cup. You call it soccer, I call it football.
No, it's fine. I understand.
It's going to be way bigger because you have all these different kind of sports.
Right.
Way more people.
Tons more countries involved.
I don't think they're ready. Based on what I'm reading.
Right.
I don't think they're ready. And remember, I think they had 8 years because
You're awarded it two cycles before.
So you knew this was coming up, and still what the things that, you know, the villages are ready, the Olympic village isn't ready for the different teams that need to come in.
Right.
I don't know. I think they should probably have backup
well, it's getting, for me, it's getting to the point where that's something that they're going to have to start considering.
Yeah, if the one chosen isn't ready, do we move to another area?
Well, I was just going to say, you know what's really sad is a lot of these countries, they say anything and everything to get the Olympics.
Right.
Exactly.
They'll do this, this, and that.
Yes.
And you know what? Like, for instance, New York, I don't know if we had the Olympics. We had the Summer Games. We had something years back, and in Eisenhower Park.
I think it was the Pan Am Games.
Yeah, it was something. Right. But in other words, we built these facilities and then we actually offered them to the public after we were done.
Right.
But you go in like Russia and China and there's like deserted areas. All these buildings they put up and they're ghost towns, they're falling apart.
Right.
And it's like, wait a minute. You know, was it really worth it? You spent all that money.
Right.
You brought in the money for that 1 month or whatever it is. Now the money's not there anymore. And now you have all these buildings that are condemned. It's like eerie ghost towns.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
No, we like when we build stuff here, we're like, well, now we're just going to use this. It's here. You know, the arenas in Atlanta that they built for the 96 Olympics. You have the LA Coliseum and for the 84 Olympics. Like we have all of these buildings now that we use because that's what you should do. But apparently with Rio, from what I'm reading, is they're not even selling a lot of tickets because people are afraid
of Zika.
Right. Of the Zika virus. Mm-hmm. And so As far as I can tell, from what I read, and me and Renee have both read some articles on this, it's like an environmental disaster.
Yeah, the water isn't safe.
They're saying
the people who are going to be doing canoeing and all of that, they should keep their mouths closed because...
Yeah, some of the stories...
There's raw sewage in the water.
They're basically saying that the waters that the rowing, the boating events are going to be used, so rowing, kayaking, all those events... That the water is so toxic that the Olympians are going to have to keep their mouths closed.
Yeah.
And it just, there's like dead body parts in the water and sewage. And
but my thing is, the Olympic Committee, they don't go ahead of time to visit these locations to see what's happening. I don't understand how the process works.
Well,
because
we could get
this is... We're literally a week or two
we
away.
We are. We're a week away. Pretty much a week.
Yeah.
A week from Friday. No, well, we can go into that. The same thing with FIFA. IOC is extremely, extremely corrupt. And that's like, with FIFA, if you want to go that route, the next World Cup is supposed to be in Qatar.
Right.
Right? And... What they're doing.
That had
right. I mean, I don't want to go into that angle because that's something I could do. I could talk about all day. But the conditions there for the workers trying to build there, it's terrible. So the IOC is really no different. The IOC is very similar in that there's a lot of back channels. There's a lot of handshakes. Right. There's a lot of things like that done. So when a country or a city gets the Olympics, it's usually not on the up and up. There's something usually happened behind the scenes. Now, apparently it's better than it used to be. Mm-hmm. I don't remember. But apparently it's better than it used to be. So, you know, take that for what you will. But when you read stories like this and you read how, like we said, the waters are completely contaminated. Right. And this is one of the excerpts from the article that I read in the New York Times. It says, recent tests by government and independent scientists revealed a veritable petri dish of pathogens in many of the city's waters, from rotaviruses that can cause diarrhea and vomiting to drug-resistant superbacteria that can be fatal to people with weakened immune systems. Now, if I were the president,
right,
I would be like, we're not going. And I know, and I would feel terrible for all these kids because
that's where my heart is. You know, these Olympians, they're in training 4 years. Right. They're looking
longer than that.
Some of them, this is gonna be their first. You have to take even a sport like gymnastics or what, you know, they there's no longevity in something like that.
You're right.
You may be able to do one or two Olympics at most.
Right.
You know, so.
Yeah, but
it's sad. They're training, they're working hard to come and, you know, just display their talents.
Right.
And to see that this is what they're going to have to put up with, it's very disheartening.
Yeah.
It's sad.
And the other thing that was like with the Olympic athletes is there for most of them, there's no professional ranks after this. This is it.
Yeah.
Like this is what you strive for and practice and train for. Yes. It's this day. It's this one event.
Yep.
And so from that aspect, yeah, I would feel sorry, but your health's more important. Like, you can't, if you go to this place and what if you catch, like I said, they have super bacteria in the water. So what if you get that and, oh, well, we can't save you. You know, there's no drug for this. It's drug resistant. How do you justify that? I would, again, I'm glad I'm not.
I mean, it's a hard call to make because I know how, you know, that these people, they train hard. They're looking forward to it. To say, we're not gonna go because there's bacteria. A lot of them.
Well, yeah. I mean, they've said we boycott. I mean, obviously it was a Cold War at the time, but we boycotted the Olympics in Russia way back when during the Cold War. We didn't go there.
That, yeah.
So I mean, it's been done in the past. This would be for a completely different reason, obviously. But just as good a reason. I don't know. It says the foreign athletes will literally be swimming in human crap. And they risk the risk of getting sick from microorganisms. So on top of the water, the housing in the Olympic Village apparently isn't up to code.
Yeah, that's what I read about too.
Yeah, so now it's not only the water itself, but you have the Olympic Village where these people are going to be basically living for 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks, yeah.
And they're saying that there's leaks going on. If everyone flushes the toilet at one time, you have back. I mean, it's a mess. It's a mess.
Again, I feel sorry for the Olympians. They're the only ones that will really suffer, you know.
Right. And I mean, I like the Olympics. A lot of people are like, I could do without it, whatever. But I like sports. So, and I'm getting to see sports that I don't get to see all
generally,
the time.
Generally, like, who sees fencing? Right. Other than during the Olympics.
Like fencing. Yeah, that's one of the ones.
Who sees rowing? I don't see that.
Like, I love swimming, and I'll watch competitive swimming whenever I find it. Mm-hmm. But again, it's not something that I'm like, ooh, I want to see swimming. But when it's the Olympics, you watch it.
Yes.
Your country's involved. It's a very patriotic thing to do.
Yes.
So I like the Olympics. But
you know, my thing is track and field because that's where we dominate.
Right. Yes. Yes. Renee, even though she's a recent American citizen, as you know, she is from Jamaica.
Born and bred.
And they are pretty damn dominant when it comes to at least the sprint races in track and field.
Yes, yes. I mean, we're branching out into other areas because this year we have our first gymnast.
Right, you were telling me that the other day.
Yes, a gymnast that qualified. I can't remember her name because my memory is terrible. But, you know, I'm very happy about that. You know, I'm proud of my island.
Oh, you should be. It's not that big a place. So
no.
When you have, you know, when you
and we have some exceptional athletes coming from there.
Well, you have one who is one of the biggest athletes in the world.
Who is that? Who are you talking about?
Do I need to say his name?
Yes. Yeah.
We all know who Usain Bolt is.
Yes, yes.
And I was like, We were talking on Friday night. We were out when there was something on TV. We were watching an event that he ran. Only one race in, but we saw it. Mm-hmm. And yeah, you know, this could be his, he's saying this is his last Olympics.
Yeah, he says he's been having, you know, injuries back problems, and right. stuff. I think, yeah, he suffers from a back condition.
Right.
So, but, you know. Well, but he did say the last time would have probably been his last. He wasn't sure, so.
I mean, you know what? If it is, Godspeed. He did so much for the sport.
He did a lot for sprinting.
Yeah.
You know, because it was, you know, so many, what do you call it now? Doping controversies and you know all of that, so you know to come out clean and run as fast as he does, I mean, it's amazing.
as far as we know
what,
he is clean
it's not as far as you are, he is clean because what people don't realize this guy has had this talent since he was a kid.
Well, most of these people have had these talents since they were kids.
No, but he was exceptional.
A prodigy, right?
Yeah,
he was a prodigy
when he was young, so people saw this coming.
Well, you, I mean, look at him, he's like perfect. If you were going to design a runner, that's who you'd want.
Yeah,
that's the kind of guy you want.
He's Usain Bolt.
Yeah, definitely. Like I told you the other night, he's impossible not to like.
Yes,
he is impossible not to like.
Yes,
like I'm gonna root for the Americans because I'm American.
And he seems to be a real humble guy too. You know,
Well, not if you read this article. Did you read some of the quotes he said?
No, when I say humble, I mean he's confident when he speaks about his craft and you know that he's gonna win. But you have to have that mindset.
No, you definitely do. To be great at anything,
you have to have that mindset.
Yes.
But when I say humble, I mean like he's not standoffish from his fans. You know, he talks to his fans.
Right.
You see how he is after a race. You know, he'll take pictures.
Oh no, definitely. He's like he's a fun guy to just
exactly. You
know, he loves what he does. It comes through. In spades, like you watch him, you're like, wow, this guy just really loves to run,
right?
Which is awesome. Mm-hmm. But I mean, the things he says, like, I know the sport needs me to win and come out on top.
And he's right, because last year was it the last Olympics when he beat Gatlin, or was it the championships? I can't remember.
I don't remember either.
My memory's bad,
right?
But when he won, you didn't realize how many people wanted him to win until he won because of what the Gatlin's past with doping,
right?
You know what I mean. So a lot of and I'm not talking about Jamaicans. I'm talking about even Americans.
No, right? No, well, he's one of those people who has transcended his nation, I guess. Like he's a world star now. He's the biggest star in the sport.
When you look in the stands, you see people from all different countries supporting him.
Yes,
and you know, I'm glad he's clean. I'm glad he's doing what he's doing because track and field has had a history of doping, you know, allegations and all of that. Gay, who was one of his biggest competitors, he was doping.
Yes,
that was one of the saddest things because I liked Gay,
right?
And I was like, what?
You know, the thing when you see guys, to me, a sure sign of someone could be using something is when you see a guy getting a lot of hamstring pulls.
Oh yeah,
because what happens when you dope? You might be using steroids, say, to build your muscles, but your ligaments and tendons and everything else don't grow at the same rate. They're not. Your muscles are growing, but everything else is not.
Okay.
So when I always hear when I see a guy in a sport like track, and I'm like, oh, he's always has a hamstring pull. He always has. To me, I'm kind of like, maybe something.
So was
on
Gay
there.
Getting all those injuries? I don't remember.
I remember watching him. Yes, I remember a few times watching him, and I'm like, he would either pull up lame or something. I remember he had. Did he race the 150 against with Michael? No, maybe it wasn't him. No. I know Usain Bolt did. I know they ran 150 because Michael Johnson for the 200 and Usain Bolt was at the time just did the one. So they kind of broke it down, and he destroyed. Like he.
I don't remember that.
I remember. They ran and Usain Bolt killed him. It wasn't even close. So yeah, but he's one of the biggest stars that we know going to this Olympics. The other ones is on the positive side of the Olympics. The other one I would say from an American standpoint is Michael Phelps.
Oh yeah, yeah, he's an amazing swimmer.
Yeah, he's the most decorated.
But look at
athlete.
How tall he is. He can just stretch his hand and he's all over.
Hello? Where are you calling from?
Hey, this is Ray from North Carolina.
No, it's not. It's Boots.
What's your take on Ryan Fitzpatrick re-signing with the Jets or going to the season?
Chris, is that you? Chris, is that you? Chris?
What?
Is that you, Christopher?
No.
No?
It's Christopher.
Okay. Ryan Fitzpatrick, what's the question again? I'm sorry.
Whether the this is Chris. I'm just kidding around. Whether the Jets will re-sign Fitzpatrick or they're going through the season with Geno Smith.
I don't know. At this point, I'm kind of done with Fitzpatrick. Again, they probably would be better with him this season at least. But, you know, he doesn't have any of their offers. So it's either the Jets or nobody. If he wants to come back, great. If not, let's just go forward with Geno. I'm not expecting much this year anyway, personally. So that's my opinion. I know you want them to get Fitzpatrick back, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Right?
Can't trust Geno.
Well, yeah, I mean, I understand, and Geno hasn't shown much in his short time here, but at this point, I mean, what would you do? Are you going to beg him to come back? I mean, he has the offer. It's sitting there. What would you do?
Nah, at the end of the day, he'll probably take it because I doubt he wants to walk away from football and make money on the table. So.
Right. No, I agree with that. He should take it, but, I mean, it's all possible. He's just like, I don't want to go through all the other stuff, so maybe I'll just sit and wait to the end, the very end, and then he'll sign. He also, did you see that picture of him recently at the golf?
Yeah, they're trying to say put on weight, but they showed it from another angle, and, he kind of looks the same. But.
Yeah, I only saw the fat one, and I was like, wow, he looks kind of fat. But, again, like you said, he's their best option. If he comes back, that'd be great. But at this point, I'm like, whatever happens, happens. I'm not expecting much from them this year anyway. I'm hoping for the best, but whatever happens this year is kind of gravy to me. I didn't expect last year, so. But is that
it?
All right, man. Chris, thanks for calling.
Cool. Good job, man.
I'll talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
That was my nephew.
Oh, hi to your nephew.
Yeah.
You know what? My friend was just texting me, too. She was reminding me, and I didn't remember because my memory shot.
Right.
We have a swimmer in the Olympics.
Right.
And we also have a diver for the first time.
There you go.
I will be enjoying my Summer Olympics this
Jamaica
year.
Jamaica is on the come up.
Yes. And remember the hockey team that's going to come and wipe the Islanders and the Rangers and all of
this. This one.
We have a hockey team, and we are going to come, and we're going to be better than the Islanders and the Rangers.
And the Rangers, yeah.
Okay, so Rangers fans.
Well, I hope you're better than the Rangers. I'm not going to lie. If they were better than the Rangers, I'd be like, okay, fine with me. Fine with me.
Big up to the biggest little nation on the planet.
Is it? Is that what you guys call yourselves?
We're the biggest little nation.
All right. So, yeah, was that? Let me see. Oh, back to another quick thing about Usain Bolt.
Yes.
Which I lost my note here. I lost my train of thought. I apologize.
Is your nephew calling about the NFL?
Yeah, he got me thinking about the Jets, and I just kind of lost my head there for a minute. So, like I said, he says he's going to retire. His coach is trying to get him to come back. He says he could probably run again.
Mm-hmm.
But he says that he feels that this is a really poor field for the Olympics. That there's not, in the guy's side anyway. So the women are really, there's a really strong track and field.
No, I don't think he meant the field is poor. I think he meant the men.
That's what he said, the men.
Because they haven't, if you look at it, they haven't been doing much. Like leading up to, I think it was the World Championships last time with Gatlin. Whatever, you know, there was a lot of hype around the times that Gatlin was doing. You know, there were other people out there, you know. So I guess he's trying to say that the men aren't putting out the time. You know, there's no hype behind the men this year. Because leading up to even the previous Olympics, it was him, Gatlin, you know, a few others, you know.
Right.
You know.
Well, so. No, he said he does. The quote is this year. He says this year is one of the poorest I have ever seen as an Olympic field for men. the women have really shown faster times.
Right. So that's what he's I guess he's trying to say the times haven't been.
Right. He says the men have underperformed.
Yeah.
But he thinks that by the time the Olympics come around, the times will be more on par with what they normally are. I don't know. Like, it's going to be sad. If this is his last Olympics, it's going to be sad to see him go.
But I'm sure he'll contribute in other ways.
Oh, I'm sure he will. You know? I'm sure he will. I wonder if he'd ever coach. I don't know if he'd do that. But,
I don't know. But, you know, he's set for life. He's making enough money right now. He can retire right now. That's how amazing is that? To do what you love and then to be able to retire at 30.
Yeah, hopefully.
I mean, I'm way past that. I can't do that anymore.
But hopefully he was smart with his money. And yes. He can. I mean, obviously, he'll probably still run.
He seems to be smart. And, you know, I did read somewhere where he told advertisers who wanted him to be, you know, companies who wanted him to be doing endorsements for them, you know, to come to Jamaica and do it because Jamaicans need the jobs, they need the money. And I mean, massive, massive respect to him for that, because a lot of people, they don't think like that. They will go where the people want them to go. But he is the commodity. He's in demand. So, you know, it's good that he's bringing them to where he is to, you know.
Yeah.
Help his nation. That is amazing to me.
No, it is. He's like, he's one of the good guys. He's one of the good guys in sports. And, you know, like I said, this is his final one, Godspeed. Good luck to him, whatever he does in his life, because he's, like I say, he's one of the good ones. So we're close to our time.
Yes, I can't believe that hour and a half flew by that quickly. We were just
Is Alvin coming? No Alvin tonight?
No, he's got family.
Oh, okay. So we don't have any Alvin tonight. No Alvin after dark. So ladies, you can go to bed now, dreaming of Alvin and his after dark show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We'll be running a rerun.
So you are?
They can kind of fantasize.
Oh, according to LA, we will be running a rerun of Alvin After Dark from 11 to 12. So you can still watch and I guess imagine what you would ask Alvin if you could call him. And talk to him about whatever the topic is they're rerunning.
Right, right.
Or you can call him at home.
Yeah, that's true. I have his number, so I could. Nah, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I just want to close tonight with something. I got some news today. I heard something, and it was a little surprising to me. And it has to do with faith and trust.
Uh-huh.
And I think, I'm not going to say any names, but I think if you're a friend of somebody, if you're working, if you're doing something for somebody and they want to change something, I think you should be told. And I think that just to keep everything as everything so that you stay on the same page.
Okay.
So again, just if you're, you know, this is a little message to everyone out there. Just if you say you're gonna do something, just be real with everybody in your life who you're gonna do it for, and that's all I want to say about that. So, anyway, this is Schadenfreude Radio. Renee, I want to thank you for coming again and being my co-host.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, I had a really good time as always.
I did too.
And as always, you can find me here from 9:30 to 11 p.m. every Tuesday night. Again, I'm Eric Holzman. Good night.
Good night, everyone.